म्यूट करें तो। गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, आवाज आ रही है। हैप्पी दिवाली टू एवरीवन, सॉरी फॉर ट्रबलिंग यू ऑन फेस्टिवल डे। वी आर आल्सो हियर इन द मिडस्ट ऑफ फेस्टिविटीज, बट सिंस द फाइलिंग डेट इज कमिंग नियर, वी थॉट ऑफ मेकिंग यू अवेयर ऑफ द new features of the launched GSTR2 and its filing through offline. तो द एजेंडा ऑफ एक मिनट कैसे होगा, ये जा रहा है, शेयर हो रहा है हमारा, यू कैन यू सी द स्क्रीन द योर पीपीटी।
हाय शशि सर, यू हैव टू क्लिक ऑन द शेयर स्क्रीन एंड देन सेलेक्ट द प्रेजेंटेशन
देयर। Can't see the PPT.
Yes, sir. The PPT is not still available. So click on the share screen and then the presentation which we need to share across.
Now is PPT visible?
No, sir.
शेयर स्क्रीन कर दें क्या?
राइट सर, शेयर स्क्रीन। सतीश सर, कैन यू प्लीज स्टॉप द स्क्रीन शेयर फ्रॉम योर एंड।
Is it visible? हाँ, शेयर डेस्कटॉप, इसको शेयर करना, ठीक।
सर, वी कैन सी योर प्रेजेंटेशन नाउ, प्लीज स्टार्ट।
सर, वी कैन सी योर प्रेजेंटेशन।
यस सर। तो गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, being a festival day, all of us are engaged in some festive activities. So nevertheless, I will take you through the GSTR2 online filing and preparation using offline. Now the agenda is briefly overview of GSTRT, modes of filing, demo and preparation of filing on GSTR portal, demo of preparation using GST offline tool, and key precautions and question and answer. We all know that the design of GST system that we are implementing involves interactive design of return, in which the supplier uploads his data and the recipient, registered recipient, verifies it and takes credit on those who get verified. Though he can add missing invoices, but the credit would be eligible only for a small period of time, unless until the supplier accepts it and pays the tax. So the GSTR1 is filed by the suppliers. He will upload data, then the data will flow to GSTR2A, where the recipient will see the data and he will then accept, reject, modify, add to prepare his GSTR2 and declare his ITC eligibility and other sections in which he has to declare his own details like reverse charge liabilities. And whatever changes or missing invoices that he uploads will again come back to the supplier. It will be visible in 1A. 1A has been released, but the 1A can be filed only after the due date of GSTR2. That is, in the case of July, it is after 31st October. So this 1A will auto-amend GSTR1, and then one will generate GSTR3 and pay the taxes. You can see this interaction in this slide also. Now, we all know that for July, the due date of filing for GSTR1 was 10th of October, but for GSTR2, it is 31st of October, and for GSTR3, it is November 10th. In normal course, when things get stabilized, the due dates you all are aware of are 10th for GSTR1, 15th for 2, and 20th for GSTR3 in the subsequent month. Now, returns can be filed by both the taxpayer and the GST practitioner. The application of GST practitioner is still not live. It will soon become live, and then the CAs will be able to file based on their own login ID and user credentials. They will be able to prepare the return of taxpayer. Now, we all know all the applications, most of the applications that we are having, they can be filed either on the portal by making direct entry on the portal, or through a GST Suvidha provider who provide API connectivity, and or through GST offline tool. We are giving offline tool for most of the applications. We have already given for GSTR1, which is already being used on a vast scale by the taxpayers. And we have released the offline tool for GSTR2 also, and for GSTR3B also, the offline tool is now there. Now, we know that over GSTR2, you have the main data element that has to be captured are in respect of inward supplies from registered taxpayers, the reverse charge details, the bill of entry details for of imports and SEZ, and the ISD credits. Apart from that, you have summary details of compounding taxpayers, nil rated, advanced, paid, adjusted, credit received and reclaimed, and HSN. Now, in case of invoices that are auto-drafted, you will have to take 4 actions that are permitted that will be there in the GSTR2. In case of the invoices which are from the taxpayers who have submitted their return, one, the recipient will have to necessarily take these 4 actions. He will have to accept if it matches with his details and take credit on them. If the details of invoice that he has with them are different from what has been auto-populated, he can modify it and take the details and take the credit. And if the invoice is not related to him, he's sure that it is not related to him, he can reject the details of the supplier. These both the modification and rejection will flow back to the supplier and it will be visible in his 1A. Now, if the invoice and goods are not received, the taxpayer can keep the invoice pending. And then he will be able to, it will get rolled over to the next period, GSTR2A and 2, and he will be able to take action and include them in the next period, GSTR2. Any problem? Now, before giving the demo, I would just briefly tell you about the key precautions you are already aware that around 46 lakh people have filed their GSTR1 and around 2 lakhs have submitted. So altogether 48 lakhs GSTR1 are there on which the recipients can take action. The people have uploaded invoices in these GSTR1 and the due date is 31st. So most of the taxpayer will have to are advised to file their GSTR1 as early as possible to avoid the last day and last hour rush. Which problem are you?
No, sir, it's going fine. Please continue.
कुछ डिफरेंट आ रहा है अच्छा ठीक है तो सम ऑफ द प्रिकॉशन इज दैट यू कैन नॉट ऐड इनवॉइस नंबर व्हिच इज ऑलरेडी देयर एज ऑटो ड्राफ्टेड इन योर पीपीटी इन योर GSTR2 यू कैन ओनली टेक द एक्शंस ऑफ एक्सेप्ट रिजेक्ट मॉडिफाई और कीप इट पेंडिंग यू कैन नॉट ऐड द सेम इनवॉइस द सिस्टम विल थ्रो एन एरर Next is taking action on all the invoices that are auto-populated is mandatory. You cannot leave any invoice with no action. And if the invoice or goods or services are not pending, are not available with you, you can keep the invoice pending and it will roll over to the next period. Now what you will see that there are saved invoices also in the GSTR2 that is there in your both 2 and 2A, which the supplier have not added. Now, in these cases, you cannot take the action of accept, reject, or modify. However, you can enter such details in your GSTR2 as missing invoices and take the credit. Now, in case of auto-populated invoices, these restrictions are there that you cannot modify GSTN of the supplier, invoice number, invoice date, invoice type, place of supply, and reverse charge flag. And you can only change the tag invoice value, the taxable value, the tax rate, and the tax amount. For these, the invoice, the supplier will have to change if these have to be changed. Now we are also providing an Excel for uploading the missing invoice and other details in for preparing your GSTR2. I will shortly show you the offline tool also and how these things get prepared. But you have to take a general, the following precautions while preparing that Excel sheet that all the numbers should be have only 2 decimal digits. The invoice number should have 16 characters, alphanumeric and allowed characters are only dash and slash after alphanumeric. And the GSTN should have not more than 15 characters. There should not be duplicate invoice numbers. And the date format should be in the proper acceptable format that is DD, MM. Triple M Y triple that is 12 September 2017. No blank spaces. One should be aware that there should not be any blank spaces in while you are entering the detail. Otherwise, the JSON includes that blank space and you are not able to file. Now I will briefly give you demonstration of GSTR2 and then GSTR2 offline. वो कैसे होगा और गूगल क्रोम कहाँ खुलेगा क्रोम तो दिख नहीं रहा है डेस्कटॉप कैसे आएगा पीपीटी पे आए कैसे पीपीटी पे आए आ गया हाँ ओए लॉगिन कैसे होगा तो लॉगिन है फिर से लॉग करना पड़ेगा. काम कर रहे हैं, कर रहे हैं वो. ठीक है. So you have to log in using the valid credentials. I am logging into the UAT environment. 1, 2, 3, 4. ये पढ़ रहा है. कुछ प्रॉब्लम है क्या वहाँ पे? नहीं नहीं वहाँ पूछिए, वहाँ पर पड़ा हुआ है. अरे यूएटी में इज देयर एनी प्रॉब्लम पूछे. यूएटी इज यूएटी डाउन? हाँ यूएटी डाउन है. वो डाउन है क्या यूएटी? डाउन है यूएटी डाउन. तो ट्रेनिंग में कैसे डेटा नहीं होगा ना? अगर यूएटी इज डाउन तो वी कैन, तो उसमें अपलोड नहीं होगा डेटा, डाउनलोड नहीं होगा. तो वी शुड पोस्टपोन इट इफ द एनवायरनमेंट इज डाउन. इफ द एनवायरनमेंट इज डाउन वी मे, सिंस द मेल वाज सेंट आई थिंक इज yesterday also, if the environment is down we may postpone it, because anyway today is everyone is busy in Diwali preparation. Subhere to chal raha tha.
Just finish the PPT.
Nahi, I have already finished the PPT. So in the meantime, I will take some of the questions that people are having, because there is issues with the training environment through which I was supposed to give you the demo. See, the first question is that export to Excel option is not available in this. प्रॉड नहीं चल रहा है? हाँ नहीं नहीं प्रॉड में डाउनलोड अपलोड होगा, डेटा ही नहीं होगा उसमें. नहीं नहीं प्रॉड में ऐसे थोड़ी ना चल पाएगा. फ्रॉड नहीं चल पाएगा. See, first question is that is export to Excel option is not available in GSTR offline utility. See, in the version that we have released a couple of days back, this facility is not there. But you can import the data in the offline tool and prepare your GSTR too. But you and create a JSON and upload it. There is an Excel file in which you can add the missing details, missing invoices and details of other sections and import it in the offline tool. Now, the facility that you are referring to will be coming soon. The development team is trying to ensure that no bugs are there and they are working on it and it will come soon. The next question is in GSTR 2 regarding the HSN summary of whether receiver needs to provide all the invert details, including RCM. I think invert supply means that all invert supplies, it includes all invert supplies and you have to give the HSN summary of all invert supplies, which includes your RCM also, because you pay anyway your RCM liability only through this return and you claim credit also. Next is the question that after when uploading after enabling accept flag in GSTR 2 offline, then error occurred appears when verified error code shows itna mismatch with number of items. See, if you are uploading with accept flag, there should not be problem. And if there is any specific problem, you may contact our help desk. There might be any problem in the if you change something. Your UAT environment to chal nahi raha hai. The training mein wo data usme tha na, the environment mein jisko download karna hota hai. Any case abhi karte hain, theek hai. To training ka kya bata rahe hain aap? What is the ID? GST.gov. अच्छा ये तो ट्रेनिंग एनवायरनमेंट में जाना पड़ेगा. What is the user ID for training environment? AP.TP2868. पासवर्ड क्या है जी? मैं कह रहा था कि आज कोई जो है उस मूड में नहीं लग रहा है. हाँ हाँ चलिए. Okay, now you can see that after logging in, you have to navigate to the GSTR 2 page and then click on prepare online or on the top to have the GSTR 2 homepage that will be visible now. You can click on each tiles and add missing invoice. Now, if any invoice would have been there in for this taxpayer, the invoices would have been visible here, but it is not there in this training environment because the counter no party has yet filed this return GSTR 1 giving their GSTN as their receiver. So since the no invoices are there, you can't see any auto populated invoices here, but you can see that there is an option for add missing invoice details. And you can give a different you can add a detail. I am going to add one detail here. 377 nahi kya SIT mein bhi chal raha hai to UAT mein kyun nahi chal raha hai? (Clears throat) So you see, you have, when you put the GSTN number, the supplier name comes. You can put any invoice number which you have. This is the addition of missing invoice. Select a date. Total invoice value. And then you can declare the ITC values. Okay. And if you save, you will be able to save it. Isme to save bhi nahi ho raha. Invoice type acha regular. You have to give the invoice type mandatorily. At least one item. One item was there added, that's it missed. You can go back. See, there are other tiles here where you can declare the other values. Import from input bill of entry. No bill of entry is found. You can add bill of entry because this value has to be added by you. Both the port code, bill of entry number, all these are mandatory fields. And you can add these fields and add a bill of entry detail. फिर उसके बाद जो है there are other tables for import of service where you have to yourself declare the invoice details and the reverse charge details and claim credit in the same table. ठीक है, this way you can declare in all these different tables. But one precaution that you have to do is you need to generate summary both initially also to ensure that all the auto drafted details are visible on this in your GSTR2, and later on after you are have entered data to update the tiles and to ensure that all the tiles are updated, and then you can generate you have to generate the preview. The preview will come, will get downloaded as a PDF. You are already familiar while filing GSTR1. And after verifying the preview, you can file your GSTR2 online. Ek minute kaise hai? Preview ke baad, once then the submit is, you have to submit this return. Once you submit, these two will be enabled. Ye to isme old aapka screen hai. It takes you to a file where you have to declare your authorized signatory and then file accordingly. Now what, suppose you have to file it using the offline tool. So what you have to do is you have to go to this GSTR returns page. You have to now click on GSTR2 prepare offline. Now when you see this, there is a generate file button here. Now in the latest software that is deployed, it is download data for GSTR2. The heading would be here would be different, and generate file. When you generate file, your the whatever file that is there in your GSTR2, in the first instance it will be auto populated file, and a file will be, you will get here links for file will be generated. One for each file will have maximum size of 5 MB, and you will have, if the file size is large, you will have multiple links here, and then you can generate one link and download each each file that gets created. You can download that and upload it in the tool. Now I have already installed the tool. I will show you how you have to do it in the tool. ठीक है. Now you see the after double clicking on the offline tool icon that gets created when you download the offline tool and then install it. This window opens. You have to take one precaution that when you are downloading the tool and reinstalling the new version, that is version 2.0, please ensure that the old version is uninstalled. Otherwise, if you even install the new version, it won't function properly. It won't open at all. Now, as I said, in this tool, there are two ways. Basically, there are two approaches to create data for prepare data for GSTR2. One is the data that is downloaded from the from the site through that download section, which has been auto-populated to you from the suppliers. That data you have to open using this open window. I have already downloaded file. I will open it and. See, already this file was there or downloaded from the portal. When you click it, double click it, you will see that it gets loaded to this offline tool. It asks you to proceed. It is for August. This file has got no records. Let me try for another file. Acha. This may be not. No records are there in this file, so we will go back.
Export to Excel option
nahi, wo option nahi hai. Ha, maine describe kar diya. अच्छा, ये इसमें होम पेज पे कैसे जाएं? होम पेज कैसे? वो जो फर्स्ट वाला ओपन वाला. हाँ हाँ, अच्छा ठीक है. फिर से आई विल ओपन अगेन. Now you see this file I have already, this is already downloaded file. You can see the data here that has got now loaded to this tool. There are data in different sections: B2B invoices, B2B unregistered invoices, and B2B invoices. There are already 24 invoices. If you double click on this, you will get the details. But this is a summary page which gives you the totals: total central tax amount, total state tax amount, total integrated tax amount, and total cess, and plus the ITC that you have availed on this. This is the summary. You can use this to verify that whether all the details are now uploaded in the, are there in your return or not. So when you double click it, this file was actually uploaded earlier. It has been again downloaded. Now you see the two tabs here: uploaded by taxpayer and uploaded by supplier. These were already, these have been already uploaded by taxpayer. You can see that the different invoices are there in this window. And all these have U flag. That is, our status is U. This means that these have been uploaded already, earlier uploaded by the supplier. Now you have again downloaded it. So they have come here. If you want to add, you can add here the new invoices by copying and say, you can make a new entry here. Or if you want to delete, you can select these and press the button here, delete. The flag will change to D. And then when you create a JSON and upload it back to the, yes, you can see I've made these the flags of these invoices. You can see that the last three I have put D. Now you can see that I had checked these two boxes and pressed the delete button. Now the flag and saved it. Now the flag have become D. When you again upload it, these flag will delete the invoices that are already there on the portal and they will not form now part of your GSTR2. Now this was for the invoices added. Now this section shows you the invoices which have been uploaded by the supplier and you have earlier taken action. Now you can see there are three invoices here. Invoice number INV3 and INV4, INV5 of GSTN. This is 04ZDDPS5160PK2C. And you had earlier rejected these two invoices, invoice 3 and 4, and kept pending this invoice number 5. Now the you can find that in the action column, you have this edit button, which means that you can take the actions of accept, reject, or earlier, or delete, or pending. And if an action has already been taken, you can modify that action also. So you can see there is a button of accept here. If now I want to change it, I can, I go back. Now, if you want to change this, you click here, make it accept. And if you save here, you can see that the flag now becomes A. Now it is an accepted invoice and you can accordingly declare your credit eligibility. And declare your credits accordingly. One good feature of this tool is that you can search invoices. Now you can search invoice for a particular GSTN also by putting here Control V. You will find that only invoices of those GSTNs are now visible to you, or you can search a particular invoice number also. Suppose you want to see INV3. Only one invoice becomes here eligible, here visible. Now, if the number of invoices are very large, one feature more is there available in this tool, that you have a pagination. You can navigate to the invoices, get arranged in the pages number as 1 to 100, and you can move to the page where your invoice is and take action. Now in this way, you can take action in details which have been auto-populated and for the first time and you have downloaded it, or you can take action on, you can change the action which you have earlier taken and you have uploaded the details earlier. So after you have furnished all the details in all the different sections, one precaution which you have to take is that adjustment of advances. This detail you have to furnish directly on the portal. Presently, JSON is not getting created, so you should not enter it in the offline tool. Now, after you have furnished all the details, you need to generate file, the generate JSON file. If you, when you press this generate file button, you will be able to save this at the location of your choice. Suppose I click here, you can say I save it in this download folder, or I can save it in my other folder, desktop, that GSTR2 offline tool folder. If you save here, you will be able to save this JSON file, and then you need to connect to the portal. I've shown you on the portal. On the portal, when you, so this was the page which you reached when you selected prepare offline. Now, when you select this prepare offline, there you will find two windows here. One is for upload, and you will be able to choose file. Abhi isme aaya nahi. Your training environment mein sab features hain nahi. Samjhe, isme to sirf invoice download hi hai. In the production environment, the application that is deployed in the production environment, you will find two tabs here when you reach the offline this this prepare offline tab. When you click the prepare offline tab, you are taken to a page where there are two links here on the top, on the left top. One is download section, other is upload section. When you click on the upload, you will be able to, there will be a button which will say choose file. When you click that, you will be able to browse and select this file, that JSON file that you have generated, and upload it to your window. After uploading, the system process again does validation check, and it processes the uploaded details, and all those details which pass the validation check are saved successfully, and they become, they can be viewed on this GSTR2 portal page, the home page of GSTR2. You will be able to see all the details in this page. If you click here, after uploading of the invoice details, you will be able to see the invoice details reflected in these different sections, whatever you have uploaded. So you can then view and preview and verify. See, the signing, the submission, all this has to be done on the portal only. Then you will be able to preview and verify here and take action. So that was basically how you can download and upload. Now, what happens is when you upload, there is a successful processing, a successful case where all the data get processed, but some line items may be processed with error. So in that case, there will be error file which will be generated on uploading, and it will be visible in that upload section. The error file, you click and generate the error file, and then you can download that error file. And once you download the error file, you have to then again open this error file in the offline tool. So yahan par you can see that you can use the offline tool to open error file. For opening error file, this is the window. You are already familiar with this. So I think if you open an error file, it will be visible like this. You can see the error message here, the different, in all these people, the message is invalid invoice type. Maybe this SEZ invoice type that was selected was invalid because the recipient, the supplier, the recipient is not a invoice SEZ unit. So that's why the system is throwing error. And you will get this error. You can rectify these errors and again create a JSON file and upload this. Okay. So this is how you will be able to correct the data which has been uploaded. Now I've already told you that you can take action on multiple, you can delete the invoices which have been earlier uploaded by you. So suppose upload this file, which has been downloaded. If I want to delete, I can go into this section. Now you can see that for deleting the data of whole section, you can press this delete section button and all the data in that section will be deleted. You select the section from this dropdown and they delete the section. And they will all have the D flag, and when you upload it on the portal, those details would get deleted. Now, if you want to prepare another sheet, you clear the data in this sheet, you can use this clear section data button and all the data will be deleted from this section and you can add new data. For importing files, I said you can use this. Now one way in which you can prepare the offline GSTR2 and the offline tool is you can prepare an Excel sheet for all the data which you have to furnish yourself. So I think I've already demonstrated you, but you can see this Excel template is there in the zip file folder which just gets downloaded. You have to use that Excel template to prepare that file, and you can upload this Excel template here in this tool, and all the missing invoice details and detail and section reverse charge invoices and information in other sections can be prepared in the Excel and uploaded in this tool in one go. Now I have selected that Excel file and I have uploaded it. If there is any error in the data, you can see this warning message gives you that in case of duplicate invoices that invoice details didn't get updated. And in these three sections, B2B UR 1006, 1007, 1008, and 109 invoices have not been uploaded. In import services, these four invoices not uploaded. And in credit note uploader, these invoices are not uploaded. So now you can see what are the data which have been uploaded. These were the data which are there in the Excel sheet. They have got uploaded here in this tool. It's getting loaded. All these data are uploaded by taxpayers. Okay, you can see all this data, invoice type, West Bengal. All the data are there, which you had included in your Excel sheet. You can then view summary and generate JSON for this file and upload it. Generate file, and you can save this and upload it on the later on. Upload it. Okay. You will see that this name is the JSON file gets created with a particular structure. Returns. Then there is a date. Then R2. Then the GSTN and then offline.json. If you are preparing multiple files on a single day for the same, you have to change this. You have to add some another suffix here to distinguish them. Now it has got saved. Take care. This Excel sheet is a fairly simple sheet. It is just like the Excel sheet that you had for the GSTR1. You see the structure of the Excel sheet that you are is name. This is 3B. You can see that this Excel sheet, in which the first sheet is this instruction, is now provided in this aapke usme. You have different sections here. Nahi, this is GSTR1 sheet. I will show you the GSTR2 sheet. GSTR2 sheet mein. This is the GSTR2 sheet, which you can see here on your computer. It has 11 worksheets and help instruction is there in the first page. You have one sheet for this auto-populated. You can see you have to declare the all the taxes that have been paid and the ITC availed. This is a slightly different from the GSTR1 worksheet, where only the taxable value and cess amount and tax rate were being taken in the sheet, your Excel sheet, and those were getting computed. The tax amounts were getting computed in the tool. But here you have to declare all the taxes that has been paid to the supplier on the invoice and the ITC that you are availing on them. I mean, these invoices are the missing invoices. For the auto drafted, you have to take action in the tool itself, presently in the present version. In the next, there is the unregistered, that the invoices that you have raised while purchasing from unregistered. Now this will be always there. In case of July, August, you have this reverse charge liability. So you have to declare all the purchase invoices which you have yourself issued. Invoice number is the invoices that you issue. And you have to declare the tax liability on them and the ITC that you are availing in this return. Similarly, you have import of services, this sheet in which you have to declare all the imported services and the tax paid on them and the eligibility. Then IPG, that IMPG sheet, where you declare all the goods that you import from SEZ and outside India and against bill of entry, their details, credit note, debit note for unregistered, advance tax, advance adjusted. This sheet presently is not required. It is protected also. You are not required to furnish any data. In any case, in the first month, you're not going to have any advance tax adjustments. And then exempted details, the inward supply of exempted goods from composition dealers, from other, you have to furnish in this. And then ITC reversals under different provisions when you are using, supplying goods for non-business or exempt, or you have not paid to the supplier, all the different rules under which you have to self-declare your ITC reversal in this section. And in this Excel, you can declare and then upload. And then this is HSN summary. HSN summary, the HSN and UQC is a unique combination that you have to keep in mind. And you can furnish your detail accordingly. Another sheet is for masters. That is a protected sheet. You will not be able to make any change. That was, I think, a brief walkthrough through the offline tool. Now, some of the questions I think we can take. Achha. Question कर लेते हैं उसके बाद हाँ खत्म हो जाता है ना question में you can see that export to Excel some many people are asking that facility will come soon is not available but you can still use this tool for preparing your GSTR2 though it is a bit tedious but it facilitates your filing if you have large number of invoices if you have few invoices you can go to the portal and there you can file directly on the portal. You have to upload the JSON file in the upload section when you click on GSTR, preparing GSTR2 using offline. Yeah, preparing GSTR2 offline. If you see that window on the returns page, when you go there, there are two links. One is download section, other is upload section. When you click on the upload section, you will get a choose file. And then you can choose the JSON file that has been created on your desktop and you can upload it. How to take input when return is, when the supplier file quarterly return, the notification, detailed notification will come and all the mechanism will be developed. I think from the first reading, you can add and take a credit in your GSTR if the invoices are not there and when the supplier files, he will accept and pay the liability. See, one question is that invoice number may be the same in respect of two invoices since recipient of supply has no control over invoicing by their supplier. See, what the system checks is that the invoice number should be unique for a particular supplier. If there are two suppliers, then the system will not throw it as a duplicate check because GSTN supply number and the invoice number, GSTN and the invoice number for a particular financial year are checked for uniqueness. Whether URD exemption is it retrospective that the notification will tell, but you generally it is never anything is never retrospective. And hence, if it is not retrospective, you in the for the return of the months of July, August, you have to declare your those purchase invoice details and claim credit in GSTR. HSN summary is required, is a part of the return that is notified. One question was, do we have to file? Yes, you have to file the HSN summary, but it is not, the system has not made it mandatory. If you don't file, your jurisdictional officer will be taking away, issuing notices to you. Are ye isme lik gaya hai na? I think we have already seen how GSTR2 can be filed through the offline utility. In case of bus, I think that's all in this session. Happy Diwali, celebrate your Diwali. I troubled you on this festival day. Okay, thank you.
Now we'll have a Yeah, we'll have a short video on the GSTR2 how to familiarize with the GStrat 2 and as well as putting up into it, please do stay tuned with that.
Stop video.
The supplier taxpayer. If a supplier has saved invoices but has not submitted GSTR 1 yet, the receiver can add those auto-populated saved invoices using the Add Missing Invoice Details option and file GSTR 2. Such actions can be taken only after the due date of filing of GSTR 1 by the concerned suppliers. Let's go ahead and explore the GSTR 2 dashboard. To begin, you need to first log in to the GST portal and navigate to the returns dashboard. The steps to do this have been explained in another video, Navigating to Returns Dashboard. Please refer to this video if you need any help. Once you reach the file returns page, select the financial year and return filing period, that is the month for which you wish to view or file the return. I will use September 2017 as the tax month for this example. Click search to view the after due date of filing of GST. GSTR 1. You as a recipient of goods and services are required to file your GSTR 2 statement as the next step. This video will introduce you to the GSTR 2 dashboard and its various sections. Once the supplier taxpayer uploads invoice data in GSTR 1, the GST portal auto-populates the details in GSTR 2A and GSTR 2 of the respective recipients based on their GSTIN. GSTR 2A is a read-only summary of invoices, which is based on the data as received from the suppliers. The invoices saved as well as submitted by the suppliers will be visible in GSTR 2A and will be indicated by their status. GSTR 2 is also a copy of GSTR 2A, except that it allows the receiver to take actions on the submitted invoices, which includes accepting, modifying, adding, rejecting the invoice details uploaded by suppliers, or keeping the invoices pending for action, depending on various situations. The receiver taxpayers can view the invoice data in GSTR 2 almost real time upon upload, even before the due date of filing GSTR 1 by the supplier taxpayer. If a supplier has saved invoices but has not submitted GSTR 1 yet, the receiver can add those auto-populated saved invoices using the Add Missing Invoice Details option and file GSTR 2. Such actions can be taken only after the due date of filing of GSTR 1 by the concerned suppliers. Let's go ahead and explore the GSTR 2 dashboard. To begin, you need to first log into the GST portal and navigate to the returns dashboard. The steps to do this have been explained in another video, Navigating to Returns Dashboard. Please refer to this video if you need any help. Once you reach the filed returns page, select the financial year and return filing period, that is the month for which you wish to view or file the return. I will use September 2017 as the tax month for this example. Click Search to view the returns dashboard. To access your auto-populated GSTR2 statement, identify the tile that says Inward Supplies Received by Taxpayer GSTR2 and click either its header block or the button Prepare Online. Also notice that the tile indicates a due date for filing GSTR2. Taxpayers need to file GSTR2 of a tax period from 11th to 15th of the succeeding month or as notified. For example, GSTR2 for the month of February 2018 needs to be filed between 11th and 15th of March 2018. However, for the July 2017 month, extended timeline for filing GSTR2 is between 11th to 31st of October 2017. For the purpose of demonstration, I will go ahead and click the Prepare Online button to view my GSTR2 dashboard. The first block, GSTR2, Inward Supplies Received by the Taxpayer, displays some basic information about your GST registration profile, the filing period, and the status of filing, along with the filing due date. Also notice that there is a small refresh button on top right-hand corner, denoted by two circular arrows. This button processes any incremental information or data relating to invoices, credit notes, debit notes, etc. that you might have added in the respective tiles. Scroll down to the bottom of the page and click the Generate Summary button to ensure auto-populated invoice details are reflected in your GSTR2. You can click this button at an interval of 10 minutes. Each time after adding details or taking any action on auto-populated details to update the respective tiles. The summary of details included in GSTR2 after acceptance, modification, and addition of invoices gets reflected in the respective tiles. These are the values of total taxable value, total tax, and total ITC available. In the GSTR2 invoice details block, the first tile 3-4A Inward Supplies Received from Registered Person including Reverse Charge Supplies is a combination of Sections 3 and 4A. Under Section 3, you can view all the invoice data uploaded and filed by your counterparties, marking you as the receiver taxpayer for a given tax period. This section is exclusively for received B2B supplies, that is the supplies received from another registered person. When the tax and ITC details show up in this section, you can accept, reject, modify, or keep the invoices pending in accordance with your records. You are also required to declare your ITC eligibility and avail credit for invoices that are either accepted or modified by you. In case any of your supplier taxpayers have missed adding one or more invoices, you can even add them here and avail credit on those invoices for the current tax period. The receiver taxpayer must take actions on all the invoices that appear under this section. If any invoice is left with the status of no action taken while proceeding with submission, the GST portal will throw an error and you will not be able to submit GSTR2. An invoice that was auto-populated cannot be added as missing invoice in GSTR2. If the receiver tries to add an invoice number same as any other auto-populated invoice for the supplier in a financial period, an error indicating duplicate invoice and seeking action on auto-drafted invoice will be displayed. This tile also covers Section 4A, which includes invoice details pertaining to purchase of goods and services received from a registered taxable person that are currently notified under reverse charge, such as legal services, GTA, etc. Inward supplies attracting reverse charge may simply be marked by checking the box Supply attracts reverse charge while adding the supply details in GSTR2. When adding a missing invoice, Remember to correctly select the eligibility for ITC as inputs, input services, or capital goods to claim input credit for eligible supplies. In case you are eligible only for partial ITC, indicate the reduced amount in the relevant field. The next style covers invoices that come under Section 5A and 5B of Notified Form GSTR 2. Section 5 includes the details of bills of entry, BOE, of imported inputs or capital goods received from outside of India or SEZ units. Please note that the port code is of 6 digits and the bill of entry number is of 7 digits. Combined together, they should add up to 13 digits. Supplies received from SEZ units require selecting the appropriate checkbox to indicate that. Please note that GSTIN of supplier is a mandatory field for supplies received from SEZ units. The next style covers Section 4C, which pertains to imports of services. As a receiver, you need to add the invoice details of all services here that you had imported during the given tax period. In the next style, 6C for debit and credit notes for supplies from registered person, you will be able to see all the credit and debit notes that were issued to you by the registered suppliers. You can accept, reject, modify, or mark these as pending once the supplier has filed their GSTR-1. In case any debit or credit note issued to you has not been uploaded by the supplier, you can add that yourself just like adding a missing invoice. However, remember that each debit or credit note can only be linked to a single unique invoice number. You can claim ITC for the debit notes that were accepted, modified, or added in your GSTR 2 statement. Section 4B captures invoice details of inward supplies in excess of the prescribed monetary limit per day received from all unregistered suppliers. Please note that since these supplies are from unregistered suppliers, you will need to pay GST on the same under the reverse charge mechanism. ITC, if available, can be claimed against such supplies. In case total purchases from unregistered suppliers exceed the prescribed monetary limit for any day, then the entire purchase for the affected day needs to be reported through a consolidated monthly invoice. The total tile for Section 6C captures the details of the debit and credit notes issued for unregistered suppliers. We should remember the rule that each debit or credit note uploaded can only be linked to a single unique invoice number. Next is the GSTR 2 Other Details block. In this block, the summary details for the tax period are to be reported. The first tile in this block includes summary of intra-state inward supplies from composition dealers and both intra-state and interstate inward supplies of goods and services that are either exempt, NIL-rated or non-GST. Exempt other than NIL-rated non-GST goods or services are those which are currently exempt through notification. NIL-rated means goods or services that are listed as taxable under the GST regime but assigned a NIL or zero rate of tax. This does not include zero-rated supplies such as export or SEZ supplies as notified under the IGST law. Non-GST supplies are of goods and services that fall outside the jurisdiction of GST. Examples of such goods are petroleum and petroleum products, alcohol for human consumption, etc. The next style covers Section 10A, which relates to the advance amount paid against reverse charge supplies. Here, the receiver taxpayer needs to add the state-wise summary of tax liability, which is accrued from advances paid for inward supplies, subject to reverse charge. These will include advances paid to both registered and unregistered taxable persons. Similarly, in the next style of Section 10B, the state-wise summary of adjustment of advance amount paid on inward supplies has to be declared. It is for declaring adjustments of reverse charge tax paid in earlier tax period at the time of receipt of advance for which supplies are made in current tax period. The invoice of such supplies may be added in relevant sections in current tax period. Just to highlight here, these are the adjustment of advances that were declared in earlier tax period under Section 10A. In the next style of Section 13, you need to add the HSN-wise summary of all inward supplies. This should include details of the total quantity along with unique quantity code, UQC, total value of supplies, total taxable value of supplies, and all the taxes, that is IGST, CGST, SGST, and CESS, paid on the inward supply. Please make sure that the HSN-UQC combination is unique. Lastly, the time for Section 11, input tax credit reversal or reclaim, is for declaring the reversal or reclaim of ITC credit for that tax period. This reversal of ITC adds up to the total liability and also covers cases of reclaiming the ITC, which was earlier reversed, thereby reducing the output tax liability. After entering all the details in the respective tiles, you can generate the GSTR2 summary by clicking this button here. This option will update the summary on the GSTR2 dashboard tiles and will allow the recipients to view the number of accepted and modified auto-drafted invoices, credit notes, debit notes, etc., as well as missing details that you must have added on the respective tiles. In other words, this option provides an opportunity to the taxpayers to reconcile the uploaded data with his accounting records and edit the entries if required before submitting GSTR 2. The preview button creates a document of your GSTR 2, which you can download and save on your computer for reference and verification purposes. Once done, the filing procedure first requires the taxpayer to select the acknowledgement checkbox and press the submit button. Please note that the submitting is not the same as filing. Submitting the form allows GST portal to make a quick validation check of all the entered details and highlight any errors that might need to be fixed. Once you submit the form, you cannot edit it, so be careful before you submit the form. Once the details get validated, just go ahead and accept the declaration that the form furnished is true and correct by checking this box here and file GSTR 2 either by using DSC, EVC or e-sign options. You can find detailed information about the steps of filing GSTR 1, 2 and generating GSTR 3 in other videos available under the help section of the GST portal. Thank you. After due date of filing of GSTR 1, you as a recipient of goods and services are required to file your GSTR 2 statement as the next step. This video will introduce you to the GSTR 2 dashboard and its various sections. Once the supplier taxpayer uploads invoice data in GSTR 1, the GST portal auto-populates the details in GSTR 2A and GSTR 2 of the respective recipients based on their GSTIN. GSTR 2A is a read-only summary of invoices, which is based on the data as received from the suppliers. The invoices saved as well as submitted by the suppliers will be visible in GSTR 2A and will be indicated by their status. GSTR 2 is also a copy of GSTR 2A, except that it allows the receiver to take actions on the submitted invoices, which includes accepting, modifying, adding, rejecting the invoice details uploaded by suppliers, or keeping the invoices pending for action, depending on various situations. The receiver taxpayers can view the invoice data in GSTR 2 almost real time upon upload, even before the due date of filing GSTR 1 by the supplier taxpayer. If a supplier has saved invoices but has not submitted GSTR 1 yet, the receiver can add those auto-populated saved invoices using the Add Missing Invoice Details option and file GSTR 2. Such actions can be taken only after the due date of filing of GSTR 1 by the concerned suppliers. Let's go ahead and explore the GSTR 2 dashboard. To begin, you need to first log in to the GST portal and navigate to the Returns dashboard. The steps to do this have been explained in another video, Navigating to Returns Dashboard. Please refer to this video if you need any help. Once you reach the File Returns page, select the financial year and return filing period, that is the month for which you wish to view or file the return. I will use September 2017 as the tax month for this example. Click search to view the returns dashboard. To access your auto-populated GSTR2 statement, identify the tile that says Inward Supplies Received by Taxpayer GSTR2 and click either its header block or the button Prepare Online. Also notice that the tile indicates a due date for filing GSTR2. Taxpayers need to file GSTR2 of a tax period from 11th to 15th of the succeeding month or as notified. For example, GSTR2 for the month of February 2018 needs to be filed between 11th and 15th of March 2018. However, for the July 2017 month, extended timeline for filing GSTR2 is between 11th to 31st of October 2017. For the purpose of demonstration, I will go ahead and click the Prepare Online button to view my GSTR2 dashboard. The first block, GSTR2, Inward Supplies Received by the Taxpayer, displays some basic information about your GST registration profile, the filing period, and the status of filing, along with the filing due date. Also notice that there is a small refresh button on top right-hand corner, denoted by two circular arrows. This button processes any incremental information or data relating to invoices, credit notes, debit notes, etc. that you might have added in the respective tiles. Scroll down to the bottom of the page and click the Generate Summary button to ensure auto-populated invoice details are reflected in your GSTR2. You can click this button at an interval of 10 minutes. Each time after adding details or taking any action on auto-populated details to update the respective tiles. The summary of details included in GSTR2 after acceptance, modification, and addition of invoices gets reflected in the respective tiles. These are the values of total taxable value, total tax, and total ITC available. In the GSTR2 invoice details block, the first tile 3-4A Inward Supplies Received from Registered Person including Reverse Charge Supplies is a combination of Sections 3 and 4A. Under Section 3, you can view all the invoice data uploaded and filed by your counterparties, marking you as the receiver taxpayer for a given tax period. This section is exclusively for received B2B supplies, that is the supplies received from another registered person. When the tax and ITC details show up in this section, you can accept, reject, modify, or in accordance with your records. You are also required to declare your ITC eligibility and avail credit for invoices that are either accepted or modified by you. In case any of your supplier taxpayers have missed adding one or more invoices, you can even add them here and avail credit on those invoices for the current tax period. The receiver taxpayer must take actions on all the invoices that appear under this section. If any invoice is left with the status of no action taken while proceeding with submission, the GST portal will throw an error and you will not be able to submit GSTR2. An invoice that was auto-populated cannot be added as missing invoice in GSTR2. If the receiver tries to add an invoice number same as any other auto-populated invoice for the supplier in a financial period, an error indicating duplicate invoice and seeking action on auto-drafted invoice will be displayed. This tile also covers Section 4A, which includes invoice details pertaining to purchase of goods and services received from a registered taxable person that are currently notified under reverse charge, such as legal services, GTA, etc. Inward supplies attracting reverse charge may simply be marked by checking the box Supply attracts reverse charge while adding the supply details in GSTR2. When adding a missing invoice, remember to correctly select the eligibility for ITC as inputs, input services, or capital goods to claim input credit for eligible supplies. In case you are eligible only for partial ITC, indicate the reduced amount in the relevant field. The next tile covers invoices that come under Section 5A and 5B of Notified Form GSTR2. Section 5 includes the details of bills of entry, BOE, of imported inputs or capital goods received from outside of India or SEZ units. Please note that the port code is of 6 digits and the bill of entry number is of 7 digits. Combined together, they should add up to 13 digits. Supplies received from SEZ units require selecting the appropriate checkbox to indicate that. Please note that GSTIN of supplier is a mandatory field for supplies received from SEZ units. The next style covers section 4C, which pertains to imports of services. As a receiver, you need to add the invoice details of all services here that you had imported during the given tax period. In the next style, 6C for debit and credit notes for supplies from registered person, you will be able to see all the credit and debit notes that were issued to you by the registered suppliers. You can accept, reject, modify, or mark these as pending once the supplier has filed their GSTR-1. In case any debit or credit note issued to you has not been uploaded by the supplier, you can add that yourself just like adding a missing invoice. However, remember that each debit or credit note can only be linked to a single unique invoice number. You can claim ITC for the debit notes that were accepted, modified, or added in your GSTR-2 statement. Section 4B captures invoice details of inward supplies in excess of the prescribed monetary limit per day received from all unregistered suppliers. Please note that since these supplies are from unregistered suppliers, you will need to pay GST on the same under the reverse charge mechanism. ITC, if available, can be claimed against such supplies. In case total purchases from unregistered suppliers exceed the prescribed monetary limit for any day, then the entire purchase for the affected day needs to be reported to a consolidated monthly invoice. The total tie for Section 6C captures the details of the debit and credit notes issued for unregistered suppliers. We should remember the rule that each debit or credit note uploaded can only be linked to a single unique invoice number. Next is the GSTR-2 Other Details block. In this block, the summary details for the tax period are to be reported. The first tie in this block includes summary of intra-state inward supplies from composition dealers and both intra-state and interstate inward supplies of goods and services that are either exempt, nil-rated, or non-GST. Exempt other than nil-rated non-GST goods or services are those which are currently exempt through notification. Nil-rated means goods or services that are listed as taxable under the GST regime but assigned a nil or zero rate of tax. This does not include zero-rated supplies such as export or SEZ supplies as notified under the IGST law. Non-GST supplies are of goods and services that fall outside the jurisdiction of GST. Examples of such goods are petroleum and petroleum products, alcohol for human consumption, etc. The next style covers Section 10A, which relates to the advance amount paid against reverse charge supplies. Here, the receiver taxpayer needs to add the state-wise summary of tax liability, which is accrued from advances paid for inward supplies, subject to reverse charge. These will include advances paid to both registered and unregistered taxable persons. Similarly, in the next style of Section 10B, the state-wise summary of adjustment of advance amount paid on inward supplies has to be declared. It is for declaring adjustments of reverse charge tax paid in earlier tax period at the time of received of advance for which supplies are made in current tax period. The invoice of such supplies may be added in relevant sections in current tax period. Just to highlight here, these are the adjustment of advances that were declared in earlier tax period under Section 10A. In the next style of Section 13, you need to add the HSN-wise summary of all inward supplies. This should include details of the total quantity along with unique quantity code, UQC, total value of supplies, total taxable value of supplies, and all the taxes, that is IGST, CGST, SGST, and CESS, paid on the inward supply. Please make sure that the HSN-UQC combination is unique. Lastly, the tie for Section 11 Input tax credit reversal or reclaim is for declaring the reversal or reclaim of ITC credit for that tax period. This reversal of ITC adds up to the total liability and also covers cases of reclaiming the ITC, which was earlier reversed, thereby reducing the output tax liability. After entering all the details in the respective tiles, you can generate the GSTR2 summary by clicking this button here. This option will update the summary on the GSTR2 dashboard tiles and will allow the recipients to view the number of accepted and modified auto-drafted invoices, credit notes, debit notes, etc., as well as missing details that you must have added on the respective tiles. In other words, this option provides an opportunity to the taxpayers to reconcile the uploaded data with his accounting records and edit the entries if required before submitting GSTR2. The preview button creates a document of your GSTR2, which you can download and save on your computer for reference and verification purposes. Once done, the filing procedure first requires the taxpayer to select the acknowledgement checkbox and press the submit button. Please note that the submitting is not the same as filing. Submitting the form allows GST portal to make a quick validation check of all the entered details and highlight any errors that might need to be fixed. Once you submit the form, you cannot edit it, so be careful before you submit the form. Once the details get validated, just go ahead and accept the declaration that the form furnished is true and correct by checking this box here and file GSTR2 either by using DSC, EVC or eSign options. You can find detailed information about the steps of filing GSTR1, 2 and generating GSTR3 in other videos available under the help section of the GST portal. Thank you.